Hello, my name is Christopher Adams. As the rector of St. Paul's College at the University of Manitoba, I want to welcome students and their families, alumni, faculty, and staff, and all of our friends to our St. Paul's College Mass of the Holy Spirit and opening academic exercises. Today, we get to officially welcome our first-year students and to celebrate those who are receiving scholarships and awards. We begin now with our Mass of the Holy Spirit, which will be officiated by our chaplain, Father Mark Phillips, who will be joined by Deacon Richard Ludwig. After the liturgical portion of our celebration, we'll be taking a small break and then having the opening academic exercises, which of course will be followed by lunch and reception. So those of you here just for Mass, if you hang out an extra hour and a half, we'll feed and water you. Okay, I hope all of you will enjoy today's series of events. Thank you very much.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Again, my name is Father Mark Phillips, and I am the chaplain here at St. Paul's College, and it is my honor, my privilege, to stand in place of our Archbishop, His Grace, Archbishop Richard, who is unable to be with us today, but sends, of course, his warmest greetings and blessings upon all of us. I'd like to also acknowledge Deacon Richard, who has been serving at these Masses for quite some time, and we're always delighted to have Deacon Richard come back. And my new accomplice, Father Wajira, who's just sitting on the side here. Father Wajira, unfortunately, had a rather serious car accident. He's still a little shaken up, so he's just going to be with us in the assembly there today. As we come into this sacred space, this beautiful chapel that has been on this campus for quite some time, a chapel which is a light to many, I invite us to begin by praying the prayer for our chapel found printed on the yellow cards in your pews. And so together we say, may the door of this chapel be wide enough to receive all who hunger for love, all who are lonely for fellowship. May it welcome all who have cares to unburden, thanks to express, hopes to nurture. May the door of this chapel be narrow enough to shed out pettiness and pride, envy and enmity. May its threshold be no stumbling block to any who are searching. May it be too high to admit complacency, selfishness, and harshness. May this chapel be, for all who enter, the doorway to a richer and more meaningful life. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Kyrie eleison. You came to call sinners. Christe eleison. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Kyrie eleison. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory. Lord God, Heavenly King, O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world. Receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone are the Lord. You alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ, with the Holy Spirit, in the glory of God the Father. Amen. And let us pray. O God, who founded all the commands of your sacred law upon love of you and of our neighbor, Grant that by keeping your precepts, we may merit to attain eternal life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Seek the Lord while he may be found. Call upon him while he is near. Let the wicked person forsake their way, and the unrighteous person their thoughts. Let that person return to the Lord, that he may have mercy on them, and to our God, for he will abundantly pardon. For my thoughts are not your thoughts, nor are your ways my ways, says the Lord. For as the heavens are higher than the earth, so are my ways higher than your ways, and my thoughts than your thoughts. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Brothers and sisters, Christ will be exalted now, as always, in my body, whether by life or by death. For to me, living is Christ, and dying is gain. If I am to live in the flesh, that means fruitful labor for me, and I do not know which I prefer. I am hard-pressed between the two. My desire is to depart and be with Christ, for that is far better. But to remain in the flesh is more necessary for you. Live your life in a manner worthy of the gospel of Christ. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
From the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus spoke this parable to his disciples. The kingdom of heaven is like a landowner who went out early in the morning to hire laborers for his vineyard. After agreeing with the laborers for the usual daily wage, he sent them into his vineyard. When he went out about 9, he saw others standing idle in the workplace. And he said to them, "You also go into the vineyard, and I will pay you whatever is right." So they went. When he went out again about noon and about 3 o'clock, he did the same. And about 5 o'clock, he went out and found others standing around. And he said to them, "Why are you standing here idle all day?" They said to him, "Because no one has hired us." He said to them, "You also go into the vineyard." When evening came, the owner of the vineyards said to his manager, "Call the laborers and give them their pay, beginning with the last and going to the first." When those hired about 5 o'clock came, each of them received the usual daily wage. Now, when the first came, they thought they would receive more. But each of them also received the usual daily wage. And when they received it, they grumbled against the landowner, saying, "These last worked only 1 hour, and you have given them equal to us, who have borne the burden of the day and the scorching heat." But he replied to one of them, "Friend, I am doing you no wrong. Did you not agree with me for the usual daily wage? Take what belongs to you and go. I choose to give to this last the same as I give to you. Am I not allowed to do what I choose with what belongs to me? Or are you envious because I am generous?" So the last will be first, and the first will be the gospel of the Lord.
Praise
wonderful to see so many people here this morning, pretty much filled the chapel. Faces from the past, new faces. Again, this is a great joy for us to come together to mark the beginning of this academic year and to do so in our faith, to celebrate the Holy Mass, to celebrate the Eucharist, to come together as the people of God. We hear these words coming to us from the holy prophet Isaiah, "For my thoughts are not your thoughts, nor are your ways my ways, says the Lord." And I think it's interesting, perhaps a little strange at times, that I find some people like to think that they really know what God is thinking, especially when it comes to other people, what's going on with other people. And I recall receiving an email, a series of emails, but it began with a particular email from someone who is seeking clarification on how grave a mortal sin is connected to an invalid marriage. Now, it's not that this person was themselves in an invalid marriage, but this person went on to say that their understanding was that there are likely quite a high volume of invalid marriages involving Catholics who, and I'm quoting this person, without thought, received the Eucharist. She went on further to say that this in turn has led to, quote, a passive acceptance of same-sex unions and transgenderism, end quote. So imagine getting that email first thing in the morning. But I'm a priest. I'm kind of used to those kinds of things. But I'm sure there were well intentions in this email. But first, I'd like to say that to presume that another person approaches Holy Communion without thought is not only to presume to know God's thoughts, but the other person's thoughts as well. In fact, I would say that such words hint at a sweeping judgment of the other person's life, of their condition, of their circumstances, with little or no acknowledgement that the person may well be in the process of working things out in their lives, maybe even with the help and guidance of their pastor. Although I would never presume to know God's thoughts, what I do know, what does seem abundantly clear to me, is that the Father's heart is full of compassion. Full of compassion. Our Holy Father, Pope Francis, was recently in Portugal, in Lisbon, with, I think, close to 1 million young people. Some of our students here today were there for World Youth Day 2023. And he made a very compelling statement. Our Holy Father said, "The Lord is clear. The sick, the elderly, the young, old, ugly, beautiful, good, and bad. Todos, todos, todos. Everyone, everyone, everyone are welcome." And the prophet Isaiah, I believe, echoes the words of our Holy Father by pointing out that God's thoughts are not our thoughts and God's ways are not our ways. God doesn't think or act like we do. Yet, some people choose to focus on only what they see from their point of view and use that as a means to bring separation. Separation to todos, todos, todos. And I think part of this reaction is rooted in a sense of entitlement. After all, we live in a culture that focuses on rewards. You can get this, but only if you do that. And so I think it's rather wonderful that we are told this parable by Jesus this morning. The ones who came first, who followed perfectly from the very beginning of the workday, put in the hard work, and maybe thought they'd receive more for it, received the same as the others who came much, much later. And some may not have done very much work at all. And what did the first do? They grumbled. They grumbled. Our faith has a lot to do with companionship. And when we look at Christ's own life, he quickly surrounded himself with people and not the most likely characters. the tax collectors, the sinners. It was a real motley crew. He didn't go to the temple and grab 12 priests from the temple and bring them and say, come and follow me. No, he went out and he found what might seem to be the most unlikely people to bring them on this journey, to be companions with them. And so our Pope's words, the gospel message is clear. We are all invited to become companions on this journey. So what is a companion? A companion is someone who spends time with you and goes places, even places that they may have never been before. And what is the opposite of a companion? Well, apparently the most appropriate antonym for a companion is an enemy. And an enemy, on the other hand, is someone who might spend time with you, might even go places with you, but not for the right reasons. Maybe even to hurt or possibly destroy you. So the question that I pose to all of us here today is, are you willing to be a companion with others? Even with people who haven't been doing what you've been doing out in the laboring fields of the Lord? Are you willing to smile with them when God shows them the very same love and reward that has been shown to you? Are you willing to accept that in the end, it's not up to you, it's up to God? Todos, todos, todos. Everyone, everyone, everyone is welcome. And so our prayer today is, Heavenly Father, God of all people, I praise you for your mercy and generosity, which knows no bounds. My dear friends, I invite us to stand as we now profess our faith together in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. On the third day, he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From there he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and life everlasting. Amen. Eternal God, in whom we place all of our hope and trust, we now lift our hearts in prayer to you for the needs of our college community, our church, and our world. And as we do so, let our response be, Lord, hear our prayer. Lord, hear our prayer.
For all world leaders.
And people who work to protect our planet and the environment, as we value and cherish the fragile gift of God's creation, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us here at St. Paul's College, may be one of many blessings as we work hard to achieve goals, strive to reach out to all who venture through these doors and to our own little way make our way throughout the world a better place. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For refugees throughout the world, especially we pray for Abdullah Efran, Mumin and Sadat, whom our college is currently sponsoring. May their shared experiences in Canada, as well as those who support them, be a lasting blessing. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all people who seek the truth, authentic witness, and spirituality through the many challenges of today's world, may the light of Christ always guide people's thoughts and move their hearts to be true companions with all and
all. Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are ill and or dying, and for all the doctors, nurses, and medical staff who provide healing and hope to them, may the intercession of our Blessed Mother Mary and the Spirit of God save them, strengthen them, and raise them up. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died and whose lives on this earth were a blessing to ourselves and to others, and for all who are mourning the death of loved ones and friends, in a very special way, we remember the life and service of Dr. Arthur Morrow, and we also remember His Grace, Archbishop Adam Exner, former Bishop of Winnipeg, for whom this Mass is being offered today. May the God of mercy welcome the souls of the departed into eternity. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And for all the special intentions we hold now in the silence of our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. We've also been asked by our community to pray in a special way for the repose of the soul of Mrs. Aijo Egbodion, who passed away in Nigeria, for her family who are here, and for all those who are mourning her loss at this time. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Gracious Redeemer, hear the prayers of your people gathered here this day, and bring your healing love upon those we have prayed for. For we ask all of this through Christ our Lord. Amen. You can be seated.
Coming home to me and living in me, I knew. for your calling unto me and me.
Heavenly Father, we give you thanks and praise for the gifts from the people of God, for the building of the kingdom of God. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we receive the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth, work of human hands, it will become for us the bread. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine, work of human hands, and will become our spiritual drink. So to receive us, to be pleased with the sacrifice we offer you, humbled and contrite hearts. Lord, wash away my iniquities, cleanse me from my sins.
For your coming home to me and living, keep me a new life.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Receive with favor, O Lord, we pray, the offerings of your people, that what they profess with devotion and faith may be theirs through these heavenly mysteries. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in you we live and move and have our being. And while in this body we not only experience the daily effects of your care, but even now possess the pledge of life eternal. For having received the first fruits of the Spirit, through whom you raised up Jesus from the dead, we hope for an everlasting share in the Paschal mystery. And so with all the angels, we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim.
Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, And once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, and Richard, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters, our family members, and our friends who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all. We pray that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, with our patron saint, Paul, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
At our Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Let us offer one another a sign of peace.
Peace be with you. Jesus Christ, bring eternal life to us who receive it. Lord Jesus Christ, Son of the living God, who by the will of the Father, and the work of the Holy Spirit, through your death, gave life to the world. Free me by this, your most holy body and blood, from all my sins, from every evil. Keep me always faithful to your commandments, and never let me be parted from you.
The sins of the world, have mercy on us. Sins of the world, grant us peace, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. For the distribution of Holy Communion, those who are prepared to receive, I will be coming at the front here to stand, and Deacon Richard will be on this side, and we'll have our servers help direct people to receive Holy Communion. If you're not coming up for communion, you may just remain in your pew, or if you'd like to come up and receive a blessing, just indicate that by coming up with your hands across your chest. Let us pray. Graciously raise up, O Lord, those you renew with this sacrament, that we may come to possess your redemption both in mystery and in the manner of our life. Through Christ our Lord. Amen. I just ask you to be seated just for a few minutes. I am hoping that as you came into the chapel today, people took note of this very beautiful quilt that is up at the front of our chapel here. This is the work of Mrs. Joan Neal, who is here today with her husband Aubrey and family. And it is my pleasure to bless and dedicate this quilt that is going to hang in our chapel. It will be permanently here. Of course, it's the symbol of the cross, the symbol of our faith, the instrument of death, but also the doorway to everlasting life. We carry our crosses in this life towards eternal glory. So I'm just going to bless the quilt, and then I'm going to have Eliude make a presentation to Joan. And then after Mass, we're going to take some pictures with some of our dignitaries. And I also see Dr. Christine Butterill here, who's with our art committee, and maybe she'll be gracious enough to come up and be part of the pictures after Mass as well. So I invite us to stand. And let us pray. Almighty God, it is your will to bring comfort and help to those in distress. Thank you for the work of Joan, who used her talents and loving hands to create this beautiful message of the love you, O God, have for all people, seeking the warmth and comfort that you alone bring to us. Bless this quilt created for our St. Paul's College Chapel. May it be a reminder of your heavenly beauty, your comfort, and the love you have for your people. When we look upon this quilt bearing the symbol of the cross, may it inspire us to renew our mission to feed the hungry, shelter the homeless, clothe the naked, comfort the weary and the outcast, welcome the stranger amongst us, and be loving to all people. For we ask this through Christ our Lord. I'll invite Eliude to come up, and I'm going to invite Joan to come for you. You might as well come with your husband, too, if you'd like. Come up together. So let's congratulate. So again, we will do some pictures after Mass. I'd also like to just acknowledge in our midst today, as we mentioned in our prayers, Abdullah Irfan and Mumina Sadat. If I could just invite you to come forward, please. They've come a very long way from a part of the world, Afghanistan. And as a college, we are very blessed and honored to be sponsoring them to come to Canada. You finally made it. It was quite an ordeal to get here, but we are very blessed by your presence and for you to be with us here today. I'm thinking this might be your first time to a Catholic Mass.
Yeah.
Yes.
Thank
okay,
you.
A little overwhelming maybe, but we really welcome you. Thank you so much. Great to have you here. And I'll just invite Dr. Adams with any closing instructions or words.
Thank you for joining us. We will now take a break and return for those who want to be part of the ceremony for our 12:30 ceremony followed by our luncheon. All are invited to stay for the ceremony and lunch. In the meantime, we will be setting up the middle pew area for our faculty procession members and the side area for our student council who will be sitting over there. These will be marked with reserve signs in case you aren't sure where I pointed to. Will all those receiving awards please check in at the table in the foyer? For those in the academic procession, please go on to room 225, which is around the corner. Thanks very much. Cheers.
The Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
The Mass is ended. Go in peace, loving all your companions.
Thanks be to God. And please join us in our closing hymn, number 683, Be Not Afraid, in our Blue Gather Hymnal.
You shall cross the barren desert, but you shall not die of thirst. You shall wander far in safety, though you do not know the way. You shall speak your words in foreign lands, and all will understand. You shall see the face of God and live. Be not afraid. I go before you always. Come, follow me, and I will. If you pass through raging waters, in the sea you shall not drown. If you walk amid the burning flames, you shall not be harmed. If you stand before the power of hell, and death is at your side, know that I am with you through it all.